issues, economics, arts, entertainments, politics, and many more. Those are aspects or topics that are being discussed, published by broadcasting mass media. Is it true that broadcasting mass media is being controlled by the core countries or high developed countries? Is it true that media nowadays is already balanced? Well, we're going to discuss in this video. And this video is all about NWICO. Tahu NWICO nggak?
Nggak tahu.
Nggak tahu tuh.
Apa?
NWICO.
NWICO.
Nggak tahu.
No, I've never heard of it.
No, I don't know.
Saya nggak tahu sih.
Nggak tahu.
Nggak tahu.
Nggak tahu.
Nggak tahu sih.
Nggak tahu.
Nggak tahu.
Kira-kira NWICO itu apa?
Ya, nggak tahu. Itu rumus coding ya?
Apa ya? Nama tempat.
Something related to Venus, I guess.
Maybe it's a world organization. Like?
Menurut saya, itu ilmu yang berhubungan dengan hubungan internasional.
It's more than that.
Mungkin itu salah satu materi dalam hubungan internasional.
Mungkin mata pelajaran AI.
Kayak suatu perkumpulan gitu nggak sih?
Lembaga pendidikan mungkin.
Mungkin menurut saya semacam organisasi-organisasi gitu.
Basically, NWICO, it stands for New World Information and Communication Order. In the early 70s and 80s, there are a lot of concern about the broadcast mass media that controlled or dominated by the developed countries such as America, England, and France.
So that's why NWICO have three different main concerns. First, NWICO is making sure that there is a counterbalance between the high developed countries to the less developed countries. At the second point, NWICO is making sure that there is a national self-determination of the domestic communication policies. And the third, NWICO is making sure at the international level there is a two-way flow of content of information reflecting accurately aspirations and activities to the less developed countries. So that's why less developed countries and high developed countries have the same rights to publish something to the broadcasting mass media. Despite three other important points or concerns about NWICO that I already mentioned before, NWICO is actually having a lot of debates because, in fact, 80% people around the world are enjoying watching products from the Western or the high developed countries, such as for entertainment and politics, social issues, economics, and so on. And also, 80% of them are usually watching TV shows, reality TV shows, movies, listen to music, and most of them are coming from the Western or the high developed countries, aka core nations. As we already know, as international relations students, I probably catch up international media most rather than the local media, but sometimes Me as international relations students also catch up the local news, local informations from the local broadcasting mass media. But I really need to admit that international broadcasting mass media that run by the high developed countries are also way more reliable to the international relations students. Is it NWICO doing its job? I think probably yes, probably no. Because it is yes, as you can see, because Indonesia is really open-minded, like trying to be open-minded right now than before, and there is a lot of free publication in local broadcasting mass media as well. But no, because it's ended up a lot of foreign countries, like high developed countries, still dominated the broadcasting mass media world.
Since its emergence, NWSEO has given a big impact to the media world. This we can see from the two-way information flow that we receive and we send to the coordination. And however, the media from the coordinations are still dominating the media as a whole in around the globe.
I think NWSEO is not really relevant for nowadays era because, as we can all see, that we still like to consume Western countries' product, either that movie, music, or even books. And moreover, there is a lot more Western movies in our own theaters than our local movie. So it seems like NWSEO is not really helping us as a developing countries to develop our own media.
Hello guys! Thank you for watching our video. We hope you can understand our topic and our purpose to make this video.
It's to help you guys get a grasp of what NWICO is. And we hope you understand more about our video. Once again, thank you for watching our video and we'll see you some other time.
Ta-da!
Tahu NWICO nggak?
Nggak tahu.
Menurut kamu itu apa?
No. Oh guys, thank you for watching our video. We hope you understand about our topic.
Behind camera effort. Here they are. Papers. Bunch of stuff.
Asiento soup. Daddy soup.
Thank you for watching our video. Guys, mau apa guys? Kapan guys? Bebas dari tahan guys.
Get on with your lives, people.
What?